Now, ladies and gentlemen, in the months leading to the 2024 Lok Sabha elections, Congress leader Rahul Gandhi had led two cross-country marches with a mission to unite Bharat. But today, a curious statement has come from Rahul Gandhi during his poll campaign in Kashmir, which has made many ask, is this the Rahul Gandhi or a version of Bharat Jodo? Now, during his speech in Anantnag yesterday, Rahul Gandhi told people of Kashmir that their rights and their wealth is being snatched and is being given to the outsiders, is a claim that has come from Rahul Gandhi. He says that the people of Jammu and Kashmir are being robbed by the outsiders. The question today is, who really are the outsiders that Rahul Gandhi is in fact referring to? Listen in.
आपका सिर्फ स्टेट नहीं छीना गया, आपके अधिकार, आपका धन, सारा का सारा आपसे छीना जा रहा है। 1947 में हमने राजाओं को हटाकर लोकतांत्रिक सरकार बनाई, हमने देश को कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन दिया। आज जम्मू कश्मीर में राजा बैठा हुआ है, उसका नाम एलजी है मगर वो है राजा। और जो आपका धन है आपसे छीना जा रहा है, बाहर के लोगों को दिया जा रहा है, चाहे वो आपके कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स हो, सारा का सारा फायदा बाहर के लोगों को मिल रहा है और जम्मू कश्मीर के लोगों से छीना जा रहा है।
Some see these comments as divisive and against the idea of India. Rahul Gandhi's allies, in fact, the alliance partners, don't seem to be of the same opinion. In fact, the National Conference and the PDP have backed Rahul Gandhi and claimed that democracy has been trampled by the BJP.
Rahul Gandhi ji ki kyun aap baat kar rahe hain? Main wo Moti ji to ye hamesha se kehti rahi. ये तो चलिए इन्होंने सेकंड किया या ये उसी बात पे आए जो महबूबा मुफ्ती जी कह रही थी, वो ऑल अलोंग ऑल थ्रू आप रिकॉर्ड देख लीजिए, ऑल अलोंग, आज नहीं, इलेक्शन में नहीं, इलेक्शन से पहले भी आप रिकॉर्ड देख लीजिए, हमारी प्रेसिडेंट महबूबा मुफ्ती जी ने कितनी बार ये कहा, कितनी बार आवाज़ उठाई है, कितनी बार इस पर जो भी कहना था कहा है और बेखौफ होके कहा है। तो मैं कहूँगा बेटर लेट देन नेवर, अच्छी बात है अगर आप ये लोग भी इस पे अपनी मोहर लगाते हैं तो बहुत अच्छी बात है।
10 साल में सबसे बड़ा कमाल अगर बीजेपी ने किया तो इसके दो हिस्से कर दिए और टुकड़े कर दिए। एक तो बहुत बड़ा कमाल है, उसके बाद यूटी बनाने के बाद जो ब्यूरोक्रेटिक सेटअप दे दिया एलजी के रूप में, उन्होंने पहला काम ये किया कि यहाँ के किसी अफसर पे मुलाजम पे भरोसा नहीं किया, उन्होंने सारे अपने यूपी से उठा के लाए और यहाँ काम चलाया। राहुल गांधी ने कोई गलत बात नहीं की है, लोग इसमें झुलस रहे हैं, बेबस हैं, सुनने के लिए कोई तैयार नहीं है और डेमोक्रेसी यहाँ कैजुअलिटी बन के रह गई।
Now you'd remember that this is not the first time leaders of the India bloc have made comments that goes against the India and the cultural diversity. You'd remember some of these comments in the last few months as well, and let me take you through them. Remember, this is the recent comment that has been made by Rahul Gandhi that wealth of people of Jammu and Kashmir is being given to the outsider. Now, there's another comment by the DMK leader earlier this year. He goes on to say that Hindi is the language of underdeveloped state, a controversial comment. This is quite a controversial comment that you would remember. East Indians look like Chinese, West Indians look like Arabs. This is a comment that has been given by Sam Pitroda that garnered a lot of backlash. In fact, he also went on to say that North Indians resemble whites, South Indians look like Africans. Another comment that has been made by the Congress leader, this is Captain Fernandez. He goes on to say that Indian constitution imposed on Goa. Rahul Gandhi said, I have a point, is the statement that has been given by him. Congress leader from Karnataka, D.K. Suresh, earlier this year said that tax collected from South, in fact, Telangana, this is a comment that has come from Telangana Chief Minister. Telangana DNA is better than Bihar DNA. A comment that has come from Revanth Reddy, who is the current Chief Minister of the state of Telangana. Let me firstly go across to Pradeep Datta, who continues to be live with us. Pradeep Datta, we have seen like over the last few months all these controversial statements that have come from the Congress leaders, but this comment by Rahul Gandhi just comes ahead of the J&K elections. He has in fact gone on to say that wealth is being taken is been given to the outside people. Give us more details.
Yes, you're absolutely right. This comment of Rahul Gandhi has not gone down well with the BJP and some other parties because they feel this is totally against the idea of India. And this is not first time that the Congress people have resorted to such kind of a fear mongering, and they have tried to divide India either on the basis of the race, caste, color, seat, or and sometimes saying that it is an outsider who are taking away the money and even the jobs in Kashmir Valley. That's what actually he said. The opportunity is being taken by outsiders, and I will not allow this thing to happen. And when I asked this question to the BJP, they said that there is no doubt that because Rahul Gandhi has joined hands with National Conference, that if you look at their manifesto, they want to keep Pakistan in good humor because they want to get back Article 3 that was not only discriminatory in nature, but that prevented all these years from people like Valmiki Samaj, women, and West Pakistan refugees to get their due rights. They have no problem when Pakistani terrorists come out to this place, but they have a problem if Indians come over to Kashmir Valley and start working there. It was basically a kind of a stonewall that BJP wanted to break, and that was the reason that Article 3 was advocated, because there was no space for any Indian to come out to this place, buy land or live there, because they had created a state within a state. That's why the Article 370 was there. So they will not speak about the Pakistani terrorists infiltrating into this site, trying to create mayhem. They will not speak about the separatist element, but they will talk about the people who are working here. If, for example, a laborer from many part of the country is coming out to Jammu and Kashmir, he's a part of a development because they are trying to ensure that there is a construction work, there's a boom. So that means they are basically trying to resurrect Naya Jammu and Kashmir from something what they had looted and plundered in the past. That's what actually the BJP is saying. So they are trying to make it an issue that from day one, ever since we have seen the National Conference manifesto had been there and Congress sitting alliance to National Conference somewhere, they feel that they seem to be the part of the same coin, and they do not want to Kashmir to be on the path of development, and they do not want idea of India to survive here in this region. Once again, they want that Pakistan-related element to flourish and Kashmir to move towards Mahim. But you rightly said, we saw the same kind of a statement coming from Sam Patoda a few months back when he said the people of Kashmir look like the foreigners, people of South look like as if they're from Africa. So they also try to, but they don't realize when we talk about India, India means from Kashmir to Kanyakumari, India is one. And that means anybody from Kanyakumari to any other part can come out to Kashmir, and the way the Kashmiris can go to any part of the India can work there. So anybody can come out to this place. You can't stop them. Because you can't create walls. Because when we say world is a global village, how come to resurrect those walls and prevent people from coming over to this place? Because every Indian has a due right coming over to Kashmir Valley and work there. But Rahul Gandhi somewhere is trying to create walls, and that's one of the reasons that there's a backlash, and the BJP has reacted very strongly. They say that he is resorting to fear mongering, and he's trying to once again divide India, and he is a threat to the idea of India. That is something we should not happen. Somewhere the Congress is playing that game where they are trying to divide people on the basis of caste, creed, color, religion, and now on the basis of their regionality also, to which region they belong to, so that they can't come out of this place, and he will not allow this thing to happen.
Thank you, Pradeep Datta, for all the details. We'll keep coming back to you for more on this. Now, citing these comments, the BJP has hit out at the Congress Party and their alliance partners, calling this a proof of opposition's divisive agenda. Listen in.
राहुल गांधी के राजनीतिक डीएनए में वही डिवाइड एंड रूल वाली पॉलिटिक्स है जो उनको विरासत में अंग्रेजों ने दी थी. जो भारत जोड़ो की बात करते थे राहुल गांधी और एक संविधान की बात करते थे, अब आप चाहते हैं कि दूसरी संविधानिक परंपरा जम्मू कश्मीर में लागू हो जाए. आप चाहते हैं कि भारत जोड़ो नहीं बल्कि भारत को भारतीयों के बीच में ही बांटकर तोड़ने की राजनीति की जाए. यही मानसिकता है. नेशनल कॉन्फ्रेंस ने भी तो यही कहा. वो चाहते हैं 370 बहाल हो जाए ताकि भारत का संविधान, अम्बेडकर जी का संविधान, वहां पर लागू ना हो.